Hey guys, welcome back to part 2 of Unraveling Marketing Ploys. Hope you enjoy!
So, okay, we've talked about influencers and what their motives might be, and we've talked about possible things to think about that might impact how genuine they are. But here is something else to consider. If estheticians and dermatologists and people who literally study this for a living cannot give us the right information, how do we expect an influencer to be able to give us the right information? How do we trust an influencer? So I'd like to hear what you guys think about this.
Well, for me personally, I would trust reviews from an influencer if they've done a lot of research and they show it. So for instance, there's this YouTuber that I really like, is Sarah Chung. I watch every single one of her videos, I love her. And even though majority of her content is really makeup tutorials, she has done some videos about skincare where she shares about her skincare routine as well as her skincare philosophy. So what's so great about her videos is that the way that she explains the products that she uses and also her own beliefs and values. She goes into each product, she explains every single ingredient and what it could potentially do to our skin. So through her explanations, you can really tell that she puts in a lot of effort into researching and she knows what she's talking about. And even the products that she promotes, her paid partnerships, the brands that she worked with, are actually the ones that really align with her own skincare philosophy. It's consistent with what she preaches.
Yeah, I agree with what Jamin said because I also trust influencers when they show that the things that they do are aligned with their own values. For example, I follow Liah Yoo, who is the creator of Krave Beauty. I've been following her since like a few years. All her videos are very informative and she also, her philosophy is listen to what your skin needs and you don't need a lot of products. So even though she has her own skincare brand, a lot of times if you follow her Instagram, you can see where she asks you to, you know, listen to your skin and just feeds it what it needs and not buy products. Like let's say her brand has this sale going on, she'll tell you like even though there's a sale going on, you should just buy what you need and not buy because of the sale. So I think like influencers like these are the ones that I would trust.
Yeah, I think both of those influencers sound great. I'm personally a really huge fan of Liah Yoo. Oh my god, I love her. I love her so much. So I wanted to touch a little bit actually on how it also translates into her company. If you go through her company website for Krave Beauty and say compare this to like a random skincare brand, the language that they use is really different. The language that they use isn't about trying to make you buy the product or make you think, I need this product. What it actually does is it's very informative and it kind of guides you into making your own decision. Yeah, so just to mention really quickly, some things I look out for when I read my fellow influencers' reviews on products that I might be interested in buying. For me to know whether they actually know what they're talking about, the first thing I look for is if they call an oil hydrating. This is my biggest pet peeve. I hate it when people call oils hydrating because they are not. It is an oil. When you drink oil, you just feel really gross. You don't feel like your thirst has been quenched. And one of the reasons why this misconception exists is because market copy doesn't help you with that. So for example, I love Good Molecules and they've got a really great oil that is so good for nourishing the skin. It's sea buckthorn oil with camellia oil. It's wonderful, except their market copy calls it hydrating. And mind you that they're not a brand that just focuses on marketing something so that you'll buy it. They actually focus on the ingredients they use and all of that. What that tells me is that the person who's writing the market copy is not communicating with the people who are actually developing the product, which is, you know, that's its own problem. It's not something we are really privy to. But yeah, so that's another misconception. The next thing is on if they know the difference between dry and dehydrated, because dryness is a lack of oil, dehydration is a lack of water. If an influencer tells you that you cannot use oil if you have oily skin, or that you shouldn't use a moisturizer when you have oily skin, that's another red flag. Because within the skincare community, it's kind of been accepted that okay, oils can help oily skin. You just kind of need to figure out what and why and what is suitable for you. And just to give you a really great example of how just because they are an influencer, they don't necessarily know what they're talking about, is Drew Barrymore talking about applying the baby facial from Drunk Elephant, which is a pretty strong AHA on her face, and then she said you can go out in the sun. If anybody tells you to use an AHA and then go out in the sun, it is a chemical exfoliant. This will, oh my god, like if you actually put that on your skin and not wash it off and then walk out in the sun, you will burn your skin. Like you won't just get pigmentation, you are going to get burns. Yeah, so in some cases it's very harmless, you know, it's an oil is hydrating, at worst, you know, you just don't hydrate your skin. But when it comes to things like chemical exfoliants, there can be very real, very lasting, damaging effects to not making sure the person who you trust or you're listening to actually knows what they're talking about. And Drew Barrymore owns her own company that's involved in makeup, you know? So it's not the same thing. Having that professionality, owning that company, doesn't mean that she knows what she's talking about, which she really didn't. So in conclusion, don't buy something just because your favorite influencer uses it or tells you about it. Whether it's damaging or not, whether they've done research or not, it still boils down to, is it right for you? Because it just might be simply that it's not right for you.
So do you have any skincare resources that people can look up on for like reliable and good skincare advice?
Yeah, I definitely do. So there is a couple, and they're also all gonna be listed below, but I'm going to talk about why I like them. So the first one, or the first two rather, that started me off on my skincare journey is Snow White and the Asian Pear, and then Fiddysnails, otherwise known as 50 Shades of Snails. They both give incredibly in-depth reviews. They do lean towards Korean beauty, Korean skincare, but their advice it's not diminished at all by the route that they like. I would argue that Korean skincare is very, very effective, which it is. They both go into very great detail, and I actually learned how to review products more effectively from Fiddysnails. I actually reached out to her and I said, you know, would you mind critiquing something I've written and let me know where I can improve? And so both of them are great people to reach out to if you are looking for more advice on building a skincare routine, what to look for in a really great review, how it works for you. And I especially like Fiddy because I've connected with her and she's got a really funny, like she's got a great sense of humor. It's a little bit dry and a little bit inappropriate, but it's really funny. The next one is, these three kind of like all come together. It's Skincare by Hyram, Mixed Makeup, and James Welsh. Oh my god, I cannot tell you guys how much I love the three of them. They review products so well and in different ways. So Mixed Makeup features Susan Yara, I hope I pronounced that right. And she's just somebody, she's got so much years of experience, so many years of experience. And what she does is she reacts to people's skincare routines, specifically I think it's the Go to Bed With Me series by, I want to say Harper's, but I'm not sure. And she kind of goes through it and talks you through what they are doing wrong or what they are doing right, what she would prefer them to have done. Skincare by Hyram, basically, I haven't watched his latest videos, but I got onto him because what he did was a truth about skincare kind of thing. So it sounds very like, oh, spill tea, that sort of thing, which in some way I would say it is, but it's very informative. It's not just a rant, it's super informative, tells you about brands and how they kind of like do things a little bit. Very much up my alley, so if you're interested in that, I would go with it. He shares a lot of information beyond just the product on why you might want to support a brand. And finally, James Welsh is like just skincare in general, you know, like he has amazing skin, reviews products so well and explains them really, really well. And what you'll notice is all three of them have slightly different opinions on different things. So it's nice to see that, because then as a viewer, I don't feel like I have to follow one thing that they're recommending. And they always mention, you know, what they like, you might not necessarily like, and vice versa, you know, things like that. And then the last two I have here are Liah Yoo, as mentioned earlier, and someone called Gothamista. Oh my god, oh. If there are two people that I am always watching who always have fantastic videos, who just give out so much information, it is also both of them. Liah talks so much about your skin barrier and understanding your skin. She's done so much stuff on acne and really dealing with the root of that. And it's not just for if you have acne-prone skin. All of the things she mentions can be used for any kind of skin. It's really meant, like, her, it seems like her goal is just to guide you. She wants to guide you and teach you, and she's not interested in misleading you at all. And Gothamista, what I like about her reviews is that she approaches them in a slightly different way. It is no more or no less effective, but it is another way of getting information. And she reviews products that Liah Yoo might not. So you're kind of getting the best of both worlds here. So I would check them out, check some of them, check all of them out. You know, we're at home right now. It's a good time to watch a lot of things, binge watch some things.
Okay, so that's it for today's video. This was a really information-packed video. We've noticed that. And if it's too much to take in, do take a pause, take a break, and come back in. But it's definitely something that you don't want to miss. You really want to listen to the whole thing, because Alicia has talked so much about other influencers as well. I think it's really important, especially during this time where we have a lot of time. We are binge watching a lot of YouTubers, but know which YouTubers to watch. And if you were to watch all of them, take everything with a pinch of salt. Like what Alicia said, they may not talk about the same things, and they may have different opinions on the same things. So it just really depends on what your skin needs and what you need. So stay tuned for the third video, where we talk about beauty myths. And if you have any questions, you can leave them in our YouTube comments or even our Instagram comments, just anywhere. We will compile it and we will have Alicia answer them if she can.
Yes, so basically it's mainly about being mindful of what we need and of what information we are letting in. Like, we have to know how to choose and pick which information is useful for us, and not just believe everything that we see or hear. So if you guys haven't followed Alicia, follow her at The Dewy Copy for more skincare advice and insights into brand behavior. And if you haven't followed us, subscribe and follow us on our Instagram at rebuilding.you, and we will see you guys in our next episode. Bye!